It's a bizarre case in western Kansas. A woman sat on her boyfriend's toilet for so long that her body was stuck to the seat. Pam Babcock's boyfriend insists it was her decision to stay in there, saying she had a phobia about leaving the bathroom.
She has a fear of coming out. Most of her fear from coming out is her relatives. She don't want to see them. She's afraid if she comes out, she will see them.
Corey McFerrin tells the AP he finally called police after he became worried because his girlfriend was acting groggy. When officials arrived, they had to pry the toilet seat off her with a pry bar.
We had to break the toilet seat away from the stool and take her in with the toilet seat stuck to her.
Babcock's boyfriend says he's been taking care of her and insists the two had a normal relationship, except it all happened in the bathroom.
I told her whether she walks or rolls out of that hospital, she's going to be home with me and I'm going to take care of her.
Babcock has an infection in her legs that has damaged her nerves, and she may wind up in a wheelchair. The couple has been together for 16 years, but investigators are considering charges against McFerrin for not getting his girlfriend help sooner. Ed Donahue, The Associated Press.
This one, I like inviting Democrats on my show because of, you know, Dan Bongino golden rule number 7, which is Democrats know a lot of stuff, but what they know is all wrong. Every single thing they know is wrong. That's why me, I'm not a doctor. I'm not an epidemiologist or a virologist. I was an NBA guy. That's what I am, not NBA. I don't play basketball, right? And I'm not touting my educational credentials, but just to show you, like, I'm not afraid to debate anyone on the left, because when you do what Gupta did, he was trying to sell a book, so he went on Rogan. You show, and Will, you've done it a couple times in that show too. They are so totally unprepared for a confrontation because, as Rachel knows, having dealt with the school system forever and the fights there, they're indoctrinated for so long that when they're confronted with reality, all of a sudden they do what Gupta did. X-lax moment, get me the diapers. They don't know what to say. Nothing they know is correct. They're wrong on taxes. They're wrong on economics, on health care, on everything. Think about it. Joe Rogan, a very talented, superb businessman and entrepreneur, but he's an MMA fighter and a podcast guy, just humiliated a medical doctor on his own show about an FDA-approved drug for parasites. And the doctor's like, oh, hold on, guys. Give me a minute. Anyone got a cup of tea so I can take a break here?
That's right.
I mean, this is embarrassing. And the left doesn't know anything. I'm telling you, never be afraid to debate these people. They're clueless.
But he's lying. There's no way that if you're the medical expert, top guy in medicine at CNN, that you did not know for months that they were saying it was horse dewormer, and that all along, whether it was hydroxychloroquine or ivermectin or any other early treatment, they have been poo-pooing all of this for months.
Yes.
And I think people have died because of this. People have died because we have been vilifying early treatments.
Rachel, this is how dopey this argument is, okay? Every sane person, again, exclude the liberals listening to the show because they're lunatics, knows ivermectin is an approved drug for animals and humans, right? FDA approved for humans, that is, okay? Everybody knows that, right? That's just a fact. That's like, so suggesting that a human who takes a drug approved for humans, albeit off-label maybe, but still approved for humans, that is also used in horses is taking a horse drug is like suggesting if you give your dog chicken that you're eating dog food. Like, no sane person.
I did that exact metaphor in the Will Cain podcast yesterday. Chicken.
I promise I
didn't
say, I love your show. I didn't catch yesterday's. But I do listen. But I did not catch that. But yes, see, we think alike. It's like, sometimes I'll get chicken from this local barbecue joint. My dog sits there, Lucy, and she knows. She's like, Daddy-O, give me a piece of that bird, man.
Give me that dog food.
It's not dog food. It's not dog food. It's chicken, you idiots. It's chicken. I eat oatmeal, too. Horses eat oats. It's not horse food. Like, this is a nationally televised program, guys, and the most watched one on the weekend. Do you believe we have to do this to liberals? Liberals, oats are eaten by horses and humans. And liberals are like, like a bunch of clowns. They're just figuring it out. They're like a bunch of bozos. They don't understand anything. We have to lecture them on this amazing show that oats and chicken can be eaten by animals and human beings. And they're figuring this out for the first time. Like, wow, antibiotics too? are used in animals? Oh my gosh, they're not animal drugs? These people are insane. Why do we have to live with these idiots? Seriously, why do we have to live with stupid people? Well, I'm really tired of it. It's my whole show is dedicated.
I will say, Rachel has a point though. It's a lie. As much as there's stupidity, it's a knowing lie too. At least at the levels of CNN. That's not
with
that's
grave
not,
grave consequences.
That's not stupidity. That's
wait,
manipulation.
I wonder, guys. I wonder. Open for discussion for this. I seriously wonder, Will. I agree with you. A lot of people know it's a lie. Like CNN. And they're not, they know
exactly.
They're lying, so does Sanjay
exactly.
Gupta. But I really seriously wonder these days what the breakdown is amongst people who are lying, like Gupta and CNN, and people who believe the lie for so long
yeah.
and never done any homework,
fair
that
enough.
They're genuinely dumb.
And
they believe like ivermectin is strictly a horse paste drug. I really wonder what the 80-20, 28, well, I don't know.
Too.
I have no idea.
It's a good question.
Yeah.
The chief medical contributor at CNN, the nice part is you don't have to watch it, and most people don't.
And
far more watch here, and that gives me a little bit of hope.
Censorship's an issue because they choose what they erase. There's the difference between hate speech and speech that you hate. I think Black Lives Matter was the stupidest name when the system's screwing everyone exactly the same. I just want to spend Thanksgiving Day with food and my family without being accused of celebrating Native casualties. We got so divided, it's black and white and political. Republicans are bigots, libtards if you're liberal. There's riots in our streets, and it's just getting worse. Y'all screaming deep on the police, y'all are genius for sure. They're under funded already, they're way too busy to work. Order food and call the cops, see what reaches you first.
I am your voice.